last week I was telling about this biblical greeting, Shalom Aleichem. And somebody told me they could not catch the pronunciation of the second word, Aleichem. Probably we may not be able to pronounce as the Jews could pronounce. The transliteration is A-L-A-I, Alai. C-H-E-M, as we say chemistry, chem. So that's the transliteration, A-L-A-I-C-H-E-M, Alai-K-E-M. And when I was doing a little bit of a little bit of Bible study on that, this greeting was used, I'll say that later also, this greeting was used almost by everybody in the Old Testament. Everybody in the Old Testament, even once God himself, when he was greeting Gideon, he was using the same phrase, Shalom Aleichem, Shalom Aleichem. And I was explaining to you the other day how this praise the Lord came. So the English people started saying, hello, 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 hello. Hello became very popular, especially in the 18th, 19th centuries. So when the Pentecostal revival came, the Pentecostal people replaced hello by hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. They shouted hallelujah. Hallelujah is a compound word with three words. Hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. So, instead of shouting that Jewish word, because that time the Christians were against the Jews. They believed Jews only killed Christ. So, hallelujah was replaced with that English, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. So the English brought this revival here also, this latter part. So they started saying, praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. So this praise the Lord became a vernacular, Kartarika Stotram, Kartarika Stotram. Jai Masiki, Isu Masiki Jai. It's all the vernacular translation of praise the Lord, hallelujah. But hallelujah in the Bible, neither in the Old Testament nor in the New Testament, has never been a salutation. A salutation. I'm going to speak to you on this morning, Shalom Aleichem. I'm going to speak to you this morning, Shalom Aleichem. Last week somebody told me that they could not get the pronunciation Aleichem. So somehow I've got that one word. Aleichem. Try to follow that pronunciation. I'll just keep your mobile ready. If you want to record that pronunciation, you can do it. Two or three times you can just play that pronunciation. Aleichem.
Aleichem. Aleichem. Aleichem.
Turn with me to John chapter 20 verse 19. John 20 verse 19. Then the same day, at evening, being the first day of the week, when the doors were shut, where the disciples were assembled for fear of the Jews, came Jesus and stood in the midst and said unto them, peace be unto you, or peace be upon you. John 20 verse 26 in the same chapter. And after 8 days, that's again the first day of the week. And after 8 days, again his disciples were with him and Thomas with them. Then came Jesus, the two doors being shut, and stood in the midst and said, peace be unto you, or peace be upon you. Shalom Aleichem. Peace be upon you. In the Old Testament, This word shalom appears about 236 times. This Hebrew word shalom appears about 236 times, and it is translated 186 times peace, peaceable, peaceably, peaceful, etc. And also 33 times it is translated into welfare, prosperity, etc. And also 5 times it is translated for safety and health. Safety and health. And 18 times in different miscellaneous ways, and also just as a salute. Just as a salute, this word shalom is translated. As we say at times, hello, howdy, how do you do? Just we say howdy. Even today, the Jews, at times they may not say the full thing, shalom aleichem, they just say shalom. And it is responded, shalom. Salute. This is translated for salute. And the New Testament, in Greek, the word irene. Irene is almost parallel to shalom. Appears 92 times. Out of 92 times, 89 times, this word was translated peace. Maybe another 3 times, rest, quietness. What do you mean by that word peace? Shalom, irene. It is not absence of war. It's not absence of war. Probably, in English there is no parallel for shalom. Peace is not even a nearer equal to shalom. That's why T.S. Eliot, in his beautiful poem, The Wasteland, he could not use the word peace, 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 but he used that word, a Sanskrit word, shanti, shanti, shanti. Neither samadhanam, nor amaidi, nor shanti, nor ilaiparadal, no Tamil word can be totally equal to this word shalom. The word shalom means, the basic meaning of the word shalom, completeness, completeness, soundness, welfare, safety, health, prosperity, tranquility, contentment with no expectations, fully satisfied, contentment, wellness, wholeness. When Jesus told that woman, go in peace and be whole. In Tamil we read, samadhanathodu poi sugamayir. What Jesus said, be whole. Wholeness. And also it includes peace. And also it includes peace. This greeting, shalom aleichem, it is used not only by Jesus, God himself, he greeted Gideon like that. When Joseph saw his brethren, Joseph greeted them with shalom aleichem. And the pagan kings, Darius, Nebuchadnezzar, they all have used this phrase, shalom aleichem. Peace be unto you, peace be unto you. Not only when they met one another they had this greeting, even when they depart, when they part with one another, they had the same greetings, go in peace. Go in peace. Even the father-in-law of Jacob greeted his son-in-law, go in peace. And again the father-in-law of Moses, when Moses was going for this great feat, the father-in-law of Moses greeted Moses, go in peace. Even you might have heard some senior people of a father, whenever we go somewhere, when we go in out station, generally, அப்ப போயிட்டுறேன்ப்பா பார்த்து பத்திரமா போயிட்டுவான். அவ டியர் சம்பந்தி, when I tell him just I'm going for this meeting, I'm going on road or going by flight, immediately our சம்பந்தி would say, அதான் பார்த்து பத்திரமா போயிட்டுவாங்க, பார்த்து பத்திரமா போயிட்டுவாங்க. This all with rich culture, with rich heritage. This path patrama paichuvanga, Bible more than 20 times. I was studying that for 2 days. Why should not we bring this great culture in our lifestyle? When some people, your own child, your own son, your own daughter, your father, your husband, they go to school, they go to college, God's protection must be with them. They say, போயிட்டு வரேன். Even they don't say, போயிட்டு வரேன், அம்மா போறேன். No, நிச்சயம், whether they'll come back or not, one shout, போறேன். The mother will be washing vessels in the kitchen. சரி. Why can't you send them with the greetings? Let us have this cultural life. A life of heritage. Mama, poi patrama poitu amma. God be with you. Patrama poitu amma. Paathu poitu amma. Let there be love. Let there be fellowship in the family. Many times, only sounds. Monosyllables. My dear brother, nobody in the Bible talked like that. God never talks to us, when you pray, God never says that, yes, no. My dear brother, my dear, this is a beautiful, David was sending some emissaries to Nabal's house. See the culture, the heritage behind it. Jesus said, when you go to your house, salute that house, peace be upon this house. Greet this house with this word, peace be upon you. So how David was teaching his young men, and David said to the young men, 1 Samuel 26, 25:5, go up to Carmel, and you shall come to Nabal, and ask him of his welfare in my name. Every king here. So marking la. ஐயா கேட்டுற சொன்னாங்க, விசுவாசமா இருக்கீங்களா? ஆஸ்க் ஆஃப் ஹிஸ் வெல்ஃபேர் இன் மை நேம். டோன்ட் கோ அண்ட் சே ஐயா அனுப்புனாங்க, எப்படி இருக்கீங்க, விசுவாசமா இருக்கீங்களா? ஐயா கேட்டாங்க, இன் மை நேம். இன் தி ஒரிஜினல் இட் சேஸ் ஆஸ்க், வென் யூ கோ தே ப்ரொனவுன்ஸ் ஹெல்த் ஆன் தம், pronounce shalom on them. His son Jesus, with all humility, I said, didn't teach anything new. What his father David was doing, when you go to your house, pronounce shalom to that house. Ask neighbor, shalom. Proclaim shalom. And verse 6, and say this, long life, live long. நல்லா இருங்க, நல்லா இருங்க. Live long, peace to you. Shalom Aleichem, and peace to your house, and peace to all that you have. Peace to all that you have. Pronounce peace upon others. Pronounce peace upon others. My dear brother, my dear sister, John 14:27. Even before his crucifixion, in the night when Jesus was betrayed, Jesus told his disciples, peace, irene, shalom, I leave with you. He is not leaving with them anything else, silver and gold, properties, estates. What is that I leave to my children, progeny? What is that you want to leave to your children? A house? Estate? Property? A servant of God? Started his ministry in a poor state. The Lord blessed him. A monumental building, assets, property all over the city, a prayer mountain, a prayer tower, wealth untold. He left all these things, a fleet of cars, buses, all these things he left for his son. His son will be with no peace afterwards. If at all you can leave something for your progeny, your children, leave peace with them. This completeness, soundness, health, a sober mind, a character, a contentment. Jesus told his disciples as his parting words, let not your heart be troubled. I got a big bank balance, some 100 crores are for there. I got a seashore bungalow. I got an estate for you. Let not your heart be troubled. Don't be worried. Be of good cheer. No. From that moment, your child will lose its peace. The one thing we can leave for our children when we depart, I leave with you my peace. Jesus said, this divine peace, he was complete, he was sound. There was hosannas. His peace was not elated. There was crucify him. His peace was not deflated. I give you my peace. That peace, his peace is the peace of God. His peace is the peace of God. In Philippians chapter 4 verse 7 we read, and the peace of God which passeth all understanding. We cannot comprehend with our mind what is this peace, what Jesus wants to give us. This peace transcends all our understanding. Peace that passes all understanding. That keeps our hearts and minds through Jesus Christ. Because we don't have this shallow, our minds are disturbed. Our hearts are burdened. Heartache is coming. We are troubled in our hearts. Because we don't have this peace that passes all understanding. Make a note of these verses, please. Make a note of these verses. Colossians chapter 2. Chapter 3 verse 15. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts. Let the peace of God, the shalom, control our emotions, our feelings. Let the peace of heart, peace of God rule your hearts, to the which also you are called in one body, and be ye thankful. Allow this peace of God to control our life. Jesus wants to leave this treasure with us. A peace that passeth all understanding. A peace of God. A peace that can rule, that can control, that can monitor our heart, our emotions. Isaiah chapter 53 verse 5. Please make note. Isaiah 53 verse 5. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes we are healed. We are made whole. We are made complete. This peace is not just an ordinary one. It doesn't come like that. This peace doesn't come like that. Jesus was to pay the price for you and I to have that peace. That peace of God. The peace that passeth all understanding. The peace that can control our heart. To give that peace with us. To give that peace with us. He was wounded. He was bruised. The chastisement of our peace came upon him. The world knew not this peace. The world doesn't know this peace. That's why the Bible says, he was the cause of our peace. He was the cause of our peace. நம்முடைய சமாதான காரணராகி. He became the cause for our peace. This peace doesn't come in our life just like that. Jesus was to suffer and die on the cross, wounded, bruised, that you and I can have this peace. That is why Isaiah prophesied after saying that the chastisement of our peace came upon him. In the latter verses, chapter 54 verse 10, for the mountain shall depart and the hills be removed. These are the occasions where we leave peace. We depended on somebody like mountain. Ungala mala pola nambi irundha. Mountains will be removed. Hills will be removed. Mountains shall depart. We had full confidence on somebody. My wife will never ditch me. My husband will never ditch me. I trusted him so much. I believed my brother will help me. I believed my sister will help me. I never thought this believer will do this for me. This believer will do this for me. I never thought so and so will depart. The day that I came for the ministry, quit my teaching, the last day, I was relieved from my teaching after my notice period. In all my life, the days that I could remember, maybe from age 4 to 64, in all those 60 years, that is the day I wept bitter, the day I quit teaching. I don't know why I was weeping. Literally, not metaphorically, literally, the towel was wet. Our pastor had come to comfort me. More than half, for nearly 2 hours, he was talking to us. I don't remember exactly what pastor was talking to us, but one thing he said, whatever may happen in the life, in your ministry, whatever may happen, nothing should surprise you. Nothing should be a shock to you. No situation you should say, "Naa ipdi nenakave illa." No situation you should say, "I never expected like this." In every situation, yes, I know, enak theriyum. I know. Later, God taught me, let come what may, it is written. Even those who are very close with me, I have gone to hotel with them many times more than I had been hotel to my beloved wife. So many times I have taken them to hotel, spent time with him, traveled with him. When I heard that he was speaking against me, my heart was broken. But I remembered what Pastor Sundaram said. I remembered what the Bible said. One who puts his hand with you in the platter, he will lift up his heels against you. உன்னோடு கூட தாளந்தல கை வைக்கிறவன் உனக்கு விரோதமா குதிங்கால தூக்குவான். வேத வாக்கியம் நிறைவேறத்தக்கதாக. This happens. Whatever that could happen, it said in the Bible, mountains will depart, hills will be removed. The prophecy said in chapter 53, he said, the chastisement of our peace came upon him. In a few verses he says, mountains will depart, hills will be removed, but my kindness shall not depart from thee, neither shall the covenant of my peace be removed, saith the Lord that hath mercy on thee. I need the mercy of God. Mountains I depended, hills I trusted, deceived me, let their hands go. Many years back, a very good servant of God, many years back, Brother Jerome Thyagaraj, who is greatly a mentor, God-given mentor for me, in his church, there was a program for children, something like a child rally. He wanted to buy gifts for all the children. So he met the pastor's son, the pastor's son, the head church pastor's son. So I'm going to buy all the gifts. On that day, can you just spare a car, your car? Car for the ministry. Because it was not easy to get an auto in those days. So that pastor's son said, no problem, the pastor's son was in church. So the day was to buy gifts for hundreds of children. Hundreds of children, not a small gathering like this. Some 300, 400 children. So went and asked that man, So can I have the car? No, in a car kuduka mudiyadhu. Nanga apdi thidirnu kai vittinga. Na apdi thidirnu kai vittinga. That man in a very sullen way said, na avangala kai pidikavum illa kai vidavum illa. Na avangala kai pidikavum illa kai vidavum illa. This was Jerome was broken. Jerome was broken. Why should he get broken? Mountains will depart. Mountains will depart. Hills will be removed. The Lord knows how much your heart will be broken. How much you will be disappointed. That's why the Lord says, I have mercy on you. I have mercy on you. Because of his mercy on you, he says, not just I give you peace, I make a covenant of peace. Surely, I leave my peace with you. A covenant of peace. I will not leave you. I will not forsake you. Mountains will depart. Hills will be removed. The chastisement of your peace is upon me. The chastisement of your peace. The cause for your peace is not in that mountain. The cause for your peace, it is not in that hill. The cause for your peace is in my suffering. I was wounded. I was bruised. To give you peace, to give you peace. When mountains depart and hills will be removed, fear not. Fear not. My kindness shall not depart from thee, neither shall the covenant of my peace be removed. Don't be worried. I suffered for you. I leave my peace with you. I leave my peace with you. My dear brother, my dear sister, Numbers chapter 25 verse 12. Numbers chapter 25 verse 12. Therefore, say, behold, I give unto him my covenant of peace. I give unto him my covenant of peace. Unto whom? Unto Phinehas. Unto Phinehas. There was a troubled situation. The Israelites went into war with the Midianites. It was a blatant open rebellion against Moses and against God, against God's value system. Moses was troubled. Aaron was troubled. Many saints are troubled. Hundreds, thousands are dying because God's wrath was kindled. But there was one Phinehas. Phinehas took his spear in his hand. Kill the people who committed sin. The blatant rebellion was stopped. Phinehas, the son of Eleazar, the son of Aaron, the priest, had turned my wrath away from the children of Israel while he was zealous for my sake among them, that I consumed not the children of Israel in my jealousy. I make a covenant with him. I make a covenant with Phinehas. What is that covenant? The whole Israel may be against you, but I am with you. I will not leave you. I will not forsake you. I make a covenant of peace with you, Phinehas, for the jealous you have for my name's sake, for the sake of holiness, for the sake of holiness, the jealous you have got, I make a peace of covenant with you. My dear brother, my dear sister, Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 6, Jeremiah chapter 33 verse 6, behold, I will bring it health and cure, and I will cure them, and I will reveal unto them the abundance of peace and truth. You are sick of your sin. You are sick of captivity. You are sick of bondage. Your beauty was turned into ashes. The golden vessel has become a pot that was broken, a shred of a pot. Watanguchi. You are shattered. The Lord says, look, I will bring you wholeness and cure. You are broken. You are shattered. I will bring health and cure, and I will cure you, and I will reveal unto you the abundance of my shalom. I will reveal unto you the abundance of my shalom. My dear brother, my dear sister, the meditation on shalom was very lovely, very refreshing to me for the last 2 days. All the 236 words on shalom I went through. Every verse I read. 236 verses of shalom. And also 92 verses of irony. The meditation was so beautiful. And I was able to see what God wants to leave with these people. It's not that I will bring you back. I will cure you. I'll give you health. I'll make you whole. And I will disclose, I will reveal the abundance of shalom. The abundance of shalom. From your captivity, from your sin, from your debts, from all your problems, I will bring you out. I'll cure your weakness. I'll cure your sickness. I'll make you whole. I'll separate everything. And I'll reveal to you, not my peace, I will reveal to you the abundance of my peace. The abundance of my peace. My dear brother, my dear sister. Number 626. When the Lord reveals His abundance of peace, the Lord lift up His countenance upon us and give us peace. The countenance of Jacob will never die. Mountains departed. Hills removed. You are taken into captivity. The golden vessel was shattered into shreds of pot. You are bruised, disappointed, sin-soaked. Your face died. Shame has covered your face. Instead of beauty, there are ashes. Your visage, so marred. Your visage, so marred. The Lord delivers you. The Lord becomes the cause of your peace. The Lord makes a covenant of peace with you. The Lord reveals, the Lord discloses abundance of peace to you. What God's peace can do, peace that passeth all understanding, peace that can control, peace that can rule our hearts. rule our hearts. That peace he reveals to us. When that peace is revealed to us, he lift up his countenance upon us. They that see us will see his face upon us. Face is the index of the mind. அகத்தின் அழகு முகத்தில் தெரியும். அகத்தின் அழகு முகத்தில் தெரியும். Face is the index of the mind. Jesus has become the cause of my peace. Jesus wounded and suffered, bruised for my peace. The chastisement of my peace came upon him. He gives his peace to me. He makes a covenant of peace with me. He reveals the abundance of peace in my life. The peace that passeth all understanding now rules my heart. When there is God's peace ruling upon my heart, when God's peace, that shallow, is ruling upon my heart, God's face, God's countenance, is not the face, it's the countenance. Mugam, mugasaya, mugarubam, mugaprahasam. I'm using three biblical words: face, visage, countenance. Maybe they all translated mugam in Tamil, but they are different. Face, visage, countenance. His countenance, our countenance will not be dead. Our face will not die. Our countenance will die. We put our head down like this. Sullen. Kappal kavunjuch. We are sad. Our face downcast. We don't want to talk to anybody. We don't want to meet anybody. We don't want to go anywhere. Everything is gone. Everything is lost. Everything is lost. This morning the Lord says, he has become the cause of your peace. The chastisement of your peace has come upon him. It is the peace of God. It's not the peace of man. It's not the peace of world. It is shallow, completeness, soundness, no expectation, contentment. That peace he gives you. Fear not. We have good cheer. He has become the cause of your peace. The chastisement of your peace has come upon him. He has made a covenant of peace with you. Peace that rules your heart. There are waves, winds against you. You are in troubled waters. All your efforts proved futile. You thought, surely you will die. Surely I cannot reach the other shore. The Lord says, I give you my peace. The peace that passeth all understanding. The peace that passeth all understanding. When you receive that peace, your countenance changes. Your visage that was marred, anda kedadainda mugam, shame, reproach, anxiety, disappointment, anger, sorrow, they are the reflection of your visage. And the kedad in the mukham. There was disappointment. Mountains removed. Departed. Hills removed. All your hopes are shattered. Disappointed. Discouraged. Shame. Spit on your face. Mukhatla umilni. Many years back, I took some of our children with Hepsi and others to a hotel. I was just telling them to help translation. So I was giving an English word, and these little children, they had to immediately give a Tamil word. If I say house, immediately say vidu. Like that, they had to give a Tamil word. So I said face. Immediately, somebody said, Moham, One girl shouted, "No, no, Munji! Munji!" I still remember that, even the scene in that hotel. Alumunji, Chidumunji. If I say Moha, it sounds more literary taste. Munji, Alumunji, and the Kedad in the Munji. Probably visage can be Munji, I don't know. Sondhuvana Munji. When the Lord reveals the abundance of faith, abundance of peace, our Munji changes. Our Munji changes. It shines like sun. Our Muham Suryanai Pola Prakashithathu. Our Muham Suryanai Pola Prakashithathu. Shines like sun. The abundance of fear, abundance of peace in us, shining like sun out there. No more Alumunji. No more Sidumunji. No more Sondhupana Munji. No more Thungu Munji. Our face will shine like sun. Because the peace that passeth all understanding rules and reigns our heart. Psalms 35 verse 27. Let them shout for joy and be glad that favor my righteous cause. Yea, let them say continually, let the Lord be magnified, which hath pleasure in the prosperity of his servant, in the shalom of his servant, in the peace, in the prosperity, in the wholeness, in the tranquility, in the contentment of his servant. This is the verse to every one of you. The Lord is interested in your peace. The Lord is interested in your shalom. You are the servant of God. I am a servant of God. Sister, you are a servant of God. Anna, you are a servant of God. Brother, sister, we all are servants of God. In the name of Jesus, I tell you, God desires your shalom. God desires your wholeness. God desires your health. God desires your success. God desires your prosperity. God desires your tranquility. God desires your completeness. God desires your soundness. God desires your shalom. When Anna and Panraj knows, I am a servant of God, my God desires my shalom. That's why the chastisement of peace, my peace came upon him. For my sake, he was wounded, he was bruised, and he wants to disclose his abundance of peace to me. Peace that can rule my heart, peace that transcends, the peace that transcends all my understanding. When Anna knows that, what Anna does? Hallelujah! Let him shout for joy! Hallelujah! Shall we clap our hands and worship the Lord? When you know that God has done all these things because he desired your peace, you can't sit like this. You should stand and dance. Oh my God! Mountains departed. Hills removed. I was broken. I was taken into captivity. God cured all my sins, all my sicknesses, all my weaknesses. The Lord has become my strength. God desires my shalom. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When I know my God desires my shalom, I will shout for joy and be glad. That is the favor of the righteous cause. My dear brother, my dear sister, Isaiah 54:10. Allow to remind, for the mountains shall depart and the hills be removed, but my kindness shall not depart from thee, neither shall the covenant of my peace be removed, say the Lord that hath mercy on you. Just read one verse. It's just part of the introduction. Isaiah 54 verse 13. And all the children shall be taught of the Lord. all the children. He cures my sin. He cures my sickness. He cures my captivity. He cures my shame, my disappointment. He cures all my ills. All ills in my life He cures. He discloses His peace. He makes a covenant of peace with me, 54:10. And He makes a covenant of peace with me. He tells Anna, He tells Premi, the servants of God, all who gathered here, சிறுமைப்பட்டவள், பெருங்காற்றில் அடிபட்டவள், ஆதரவற்றவள். Verse 11, He tells everybody, I desire your peace, not only your peace, not only your peace, not only your peace, I'll take care of your children and the children of your children. Dear brother, dear sister, face to face, face to face, I love to say, Anna, Premi, just like that, just take you and me, in oath. The Lord tells you, when I disclose my peace to you, my dear daughter, my dear sir, I'll take care of your children and the children of your children. Their peace shall be great. Their peace shall be great. Your son, your daughter, their future, their families will also inherit this shalom. My dear brother, my dear sister, who can inherit this shalom? I got 10 points to share with you. And to whom the Lord gives this peace, the peace that passeth all understanding, the peace of God, the peace Jesus wanted to leave with His disciples. Unto whom, God willing, I'll continue next week. Shall we close our eyes? Please don't miss next week. Bring others with you, those who want this peace. That will be a total message to them. God wants to give His people this peace, peace that passeth all understanding. Allow to pray for everybody. But the Lord wants me to have a personal prayer with you. Maybe to all, but certainly to those who feel. It is the message, it's the prophetic message of the Lord to me. The Lord has spoken to me. You are sick, you are weak, you are broken, you are disappointed, you are discouraged. The whole world is against you. You are in darkness, you are walking in the valley of the shadow of death. Darkness has shrouded you. Uncertainties scattered. If you know this is the word of God to you, if you want me to pray for you, to pray with you, kindly stand to your feet. If you know the Lord has spoken to you, I see many people standing to your feet, even those who are joining us at the web stream, you just stand to your feet. Hallelujah. Urisha nadi namaravadi nama. Don't be ashamed. Allow to pray with you. Dear Father God, we thank you, we praise you, we worship you for this morning. Thank you for the word that you have sent to your people. Lord, as your servant, I pray that you leave your peace
with your people.
Grant unto your people your peace, peace of God, peace that passeth all understanding, your peace that can rule, control, monitor, guide their hearts, disclose, reveal the abundance of your peace in their lives. Mountains have departed from them, O Lord. Hills have ditched them, O Lord. They are sick. They are worried about the uncertain future, O Lord. There are some mothers worried about their children, O Lord. The future of their children. When you make a covenant of peace with them, the Lord wants me to tell you, brother, sister. When the Lord makes a covenant of peace with you, very personally the Lord tells you, it is for your children and the children of children. Bless your people. Send them back home with your heavenly peace. In Jesus' matchless name, we pray.